interesting. I guess we should get started. We're just going to let people keep walking in, I guess. There was, my sister said she's caught in that traffic right now. How you doing? I'm John. Nice to see you. You made it. You're like the secret angel coming in. Well, welcome everyone to Unity of Jupiter. Nice to see everyone today. I guess there's an accident. I'm in Indian Town Road, so we have some people who are stuck in traffic, so we'll just sort of keep the doors open and let them walk in as they come. So we have a special day because we have a wedding after the service today. So our beautiful bride is here, Debbie Dargavel. And we're still waiting to see if the groom's going to show up or not. No, he was already here once. So anyway, I am Reverend John Denny. Welcome to Unity of Jupiter. We are an out-of-this-world spiritual community. Super happy to be here. Super happy to have our special musical guest, David Goodman, here today. And super excited to come together. It's a big day for me. First time I'm actually doing a wedding here. So we'll just let people keep filtering in, but we'll get started. So let us get started with our statement of faith found on the monitor. And if you'll want to join me in this, there is only one presence and one power in the universe, God the good omnipotent. And now let us just take a breath. Center ourselves and come into this moment, just quieting the sounds of life. Remembering the kingdom of God is within each and every one of us. Let us take this time to bring your focus and your attention up to the top of the head, where we connect with this one power, this one presence, God the good omnipotent. And God is omnipresent, everywhere present at the same time. Omnipotent, all-powerful, and omniscient, all-knowing, knowing everything we need at any given time before we even need it. Before we even know what we need, God already knows exactly what we need. So let us just say thank you, thank you, thank you, God. Let me say thank you for coming this morning and choosing to spend it with us. And if no one's told you today that they love you, let me be the first. I love you. And I love you so much, you have no idea. And if you have not told anyone you love them, I'd like you to turn to the person next to you and tell them you love them. I love you, David. Thank you, thank you. Love you too. And it looks like the groom has made it. So we're going to have a wedding after all. So now, if you'd like to rise and we will sing our opening song, My Soul is Welcome Here, along with our. Oh! Yeah, and today's affirmation. Today's talk is called The Currents of Life. So we're going to look at it a few different ways. But today's affirmation, I am plugging in. And that's what we have to do. We have to plug into God just like we plug into the electricity. And that's what we'll be talking about today, plugging in. So now, if you'll rise and sing our opening song, My Soul is Welcome Here, with David and Catherine.
Choir people want to come up? Come on and sing with us. Kitika, Carol.
Can you needs all the help I can get, I'll tell you that. I'll probably have to read it. Welcome here. All right, what a beautiful day for a wedding. All right. This is called The Gift. There's a light that shines through the darkness, through the veil of the shadows you fear. Hiding behind the clouds you thought ruled your skies. But if you just take a moment to slow down, silence the chatter you hear. Be still just until the sun shines again in your eyes. When turbulent tides overcome you, hurricanes blow through your life, and the walls you believed would protect you come tumbling down. Soon enough, the rain will stop falling. Dawn will forsake the night. And I forgot the words. Well, you get the idea. It's my song. I'll mess it up if I want to. And love is all. take with us. Love is all we must do, and love is still the answer we always knew. Love is the blessed creator. Love is the song we all sing. Love is the gift I bring. Love is everything. When you're fixed on the rearview mirror, counting losses and sorrows and shame, you might run off the road and never see what lies ahead. For we've all burned some bridges behind us, and we're all flying blind in the wind. One thing that's certain is love when it's all done and said. Someone to love you, someone who will always be there. It's not her, it's not him. Look within, it's always been you. We can walk close together a short while, share our stories, our tears, and our smiles. When the door and roads and finally open, one will walk through. Love is all we take with us. Love is all we must do. And love is still the answer we always knew. And love is the blessed creator. Love is the song we all sing. Love is a gift I bring. Love is everything. Love is a blessed creator. Love is a song we all sing. Love is the gift. Love. Right back there. Thank you.
Thank you, David. That was awesome. So welcome, everyone. I'm so glad to see everybody here. My name is Scott Walter. So before we get going, anybody here for a first time? The wedding party. Right. The wedding party's here for the first time. That's great. That's awesome. Looking forward to that. So let's start with today's daily word. Today's daily word is healing. And if you guys could affirm with me the affirmation on the monitor, God's healing power is moving through me. I am open and receptive to God's healing power within me and within my dear ones. I trust with absolute faith that God is greater than any worldly condition. I cannot limit God. I listen to the still small voice within, and I feel guided along my healing journey. If I fear and worry get the better of me, I start to feel anxious. I call forth the healing power in the indwelling Christ. I spiritually surrender my concerns. When I pray for my dear ones, I do not focus on their condition. Rather, I see them as divine beings. The divine beings they are, whole, prosperous, and spiritually perfect. As I pray, I perceive God's healing presence moving through me and my beloveds. The presence of this health is beyond the illness, the abundance beyond the insufficiencies, and the life beyond death. This is the truth of my life. Today's daily word is inspired by Isaiah 58:8. your healing shall spring up quickly. Awesome. All right, let's do some quick announcements. Calling all new members. So we've had several requests to become members of Uni of Jupiter. There's a new member applications. You can find them out in the foyer or check in the office. If you would like to become a member, please fill one out and leave it with Carol. If there's enough applicants, we will schedule a new members induction sometime in May. All right. Pam Jostin is offering prayer chaplain training for the weekend of April 26th and 27th with the induction of new prayer chaplains at her Sunday morning service on the 28th. The training will start Friday night, 26th, at 6 p.m., and continue all day Saturday, the 27th. This church is fortunate to have the prayer chaplain team that we have. We are very fortunate. If you'd like to become part of this powerful group, please leave your name, phone number, and email address on the sign-up sheet in the foyer. There will be a sound healing presence in the moment with Joy Addle and Stacy McDonald. This is going to happen on Friday evening, April 19th at 7 p.m. Sound healing is self-healing and can be used to enhance wellness, personal growth, reduce stress, engage in deeper healing. Come to feel the positive energy while you adjust your body. Yeah, oh, absolutely. I'm going to get to her. I didn't forget you, Joy. I got you. If you'll need to bring a yoga mat, a blanket, and a pillow, and wear comfy clothes. Now, Joy, would you have anything to add? We have an announcement slide for weekly announcements, or do we not do that anymore? Okay, all right, not done here. All right, now let's lead us into meditation. We'll all join in singing Surely the Presence.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel God's mighty power and God's grace. There's a holy hush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Now I invite you all to find a comfortable place. Close your eyes if you wish. And let us remember the kingdom of God is within each and every one of us. And Charles Fillmore told us over and over again, it's right up in the top of the head. The kingdom of God is within you. This is where we find our Christ consciousness. So let us relax our minds into Christ consciousness now. I and my Father are one. Relaxing into that place of total unity, total oneness, where all is well all the time. And as we go into prayer and meditation, remember today's thought is the currents of life, so we have polarities. It's hard to know what relaxation is if we don't know what tension is. Hard to know what perfect health is unless we understand what illness is. Hard to understand abundant supply unless we know what lack and want are. So we live in a world of duality. And luckily, unity teaches us how to go to the polarity of positivity, into the place where we can affirm our truth with a capital T, becoming one with God's truth. So take a deep breath and relax the entire body, just letting go of all the tension, all the worries, all the doubt that we find out in the world. We come to this place of perfection. perfect relaxation, perfect calmness, perfect peace. And in this kingdom of God, we find the first principle of health, God's natural condition. So let us establish this in mind by realizing that God is, I am, perfect health now. Filling ourselves and each other with the color of orange, the color of perfect health. Radiant, vital, dynamic health now. If you have those who've asked us to pray for them in health as we're all in this consciousness, just see them in your mind, radiating perfect health now. Let us realize perfect harmony. Again, this is God's natural condition. We see it all in nature. We see it everywhere we look. So let us make it a part of ourselves through this realization that God is, I am, perfect harmony now. Filling ourselves with the color of sky blue, the blue of the sky. I am perfect harmony. And we send this thought of perfect harmony out to each other. The power of God working through us. The power of love that we listen to in David's song, filling each and every one of us. You are the light of the world. We're each like sunshine, sending this love out to each other. To everyone we come in contact with today. And to anyone we may hold any judgments or resentments against, universal harmony filling each and every one of those people. And together as a community, let us send universal harmony out to our planet, particularly to the Middle East and all the disrest, to Israel, to all the people going through wars, Ukraine and Russia and all the people who are starting the wars and in the wars, letting them understand there is a higher way, a way of love, a way of acceptance, a way of forgiveness. We can send it out to each and every place where there's disharmony in the world. Now let us make the realization of abundant supply. Again, this is one of God's natural laws. Enough and to spare for every need. We see it all in nature. All the different plants getting along in perfect harmony. We see abundant supply. They each take what they need. Never more, never less. So make this realization for yourself that I and my abundance are one. Enough and to spare for every need now, filling ourselves with apple green and filling each other with this thought of abundant supply. We know one person's abundance can never ever take from another. So we always want for others what we want for ourselves. Like I said before, if we understand what lack and want are, we can understand what abundance is. So accept this abundance for yourself. You can never use another person's abundance. I am abundant supply. Now for gratitude. Gratitude is the attitude which opens doors to all blessings. It creates a magnetic field around us, bringing all the things we need to us. So let us realize something to be grateful for. Grateful for the wedding of Debbie and Michael today. Grateful that we can all be here communing together. But in the silence, be ye thankful. Letting this thought and feeling of gratitude well up inside you in the silence. nice to hear the sound of a child. And let us realize and bring this thought of gratitude within our bodies, within our auras, realizing I am grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And knowing, feeling this thought of gratitude will brighten our day and everyone we come in contact with. I am grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. The final prayer is called right action. This is placing things into God's hands, removing them from our physical beings and putting them to a higher place. And we know that with God, all things are possible. And we're working with an omniscient God, all-knowing. So whatever problems or worries or visions and dreams you may be having right now, put them in God's hands, knowing all is working out in perfect order. In the light of truth, say thank you, God. Universal God, we thank thee for the opportunity of coming together, thinking the same thoughts at the same time, just for a moment, getting in an attitude of oneness, an attitude of total love. This is really what unity is all about. Now, to finish this time of prayer and meditation, if you'll join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Well, when John told me about what his message was going to be today, I remember back 14 years ago, when I played here, and I was doing it more frequently, and a lot of the songs that I wrote and we did were around Diane's messages. I thought of one that she had a similar message, not probably the same. So I dug up this song. I'm going to have to read the lyrics because I haven't sung it in 14 years. And I got up at 6 o'clock this morning and started singing it, and that was terrible. You'd be glad you weren't there, but listen to the wind blow, whispers in the trees, and beneath the rainbow, softly in the breeze, waking to the morning songs, birds begin to sing. Step beyond the passing night into the light of spring. Everything in magic motion, rising sun, sinking moon, spinning earth, waves of ocean, synchrony in tune. Everything in perfect timing, fragrant potpourri, like tumbling words that end up rhyming, harmonious and free. Just the way your life goes, falling into place. Watch it from a window, see it on your face. Even with your eyes closed, you always find your way. Even when the storm blows, you're in the arms grace. Everything in magic motion, rising sun, sinking moon, spinning earth, waves of oceans, synchrony in tune. Everything in perfect timing, fragrant potpourri,
tumbling words that end up rhyming, harmonious and free. The starlight, still without a sound, fearless through the long night, ever morning bound. Listen to the wind blow, take a giant leap out into the unknown, mysterious and deep. Everything will work its way out. Just you wait and see. Even in your moments of doubt, serendipity. That's the way that God designed it. That's how it's meant to be. He always has his hand behind it. Serendipity. Listen to the wind blow. Whispers to the trees. Bend beneath the rainbow, softly in the breeze. Waking to the morning songs, birds begin to sing. Step beyond the passing night into the light of spring. Everything in magic motion, rising sun, sinking moon, spinning earth, waves of ocean. Synchrony in tune, everything in perfect timing, fragrant potpourri, tumbling words that end up rhyming, harmonious and free. Serendipity, serendipity. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, David. Harmonious and free. That's what we try to be around here, harmonious and free. Ah, what a great day. Get to meet your families and friends, and really looking forward to this day. So my sermon today is called The Currents of Life. And people always say to me, well, how do you figure out what you're going to talk about? You know, where do you come up with your ideas? There really are no new ideas in life, so I just take them from Charles Fillmore's old sermons, or I have piles of boxes of sermons at my house from some different teachers. And so I just sort of find ones that I thought. And Charles Fillmore gave a talk under the same name in like 1936, and I doubt any of us heard it, so we'll... I won't call it my own, but, you know, I can take some artistic licensing. There you go. So my scripture this morning is taken from John 8:23. You are from below, I am from above. You are of this world, I am not of this world. That's what I talk about all the time, learning to be in this world but not get sucked in to this world. Trying to stay a little bit higher, a little bit further up. And that's what I think that the Fillmore's really taught us, is that how to change our thoughts and change our minds so that we don't get dragged into the drudges of life. And as we talk about in Unity, one of the five pillars of Unity is the Fillmore's philosophy. And it's an incredibly simple philosophy. So the way I'm going to look at currents today is three ways. One was the current of water, so how water flows down a river. One is electricity, how we have positive and negative in electricity. We need both, by the way. And how we create a positive vibration, the flow of our vibes. There's a great story which Diane has told a bunch of times, but hopefully some of you have not heard it. But it's from the book Illusions by Richard Bach. And it said, there once lived a village of creatures, at the bottom of the ocean, at the bottom of the great crystal river. And the current of the river swept silently above them, young and old, rich and poor, good and evil. The water just flowed on its own, knowing only its crystal self. And each creature in its own manner clung tightly to the twigs and the rocks of the river at the bottom. For clinging was their way of life. Clinging, clinging, clinging. And each of them resisted the current since the day of their birth. But one creature said out loud, "I'm tired of clinging. I'm going to let go. Though I cannot see it with my eyes, I trust the current knows where it's going. So I shall let go. Or if I keep clinging, I will die of boredom." And the other creatures laughed and they said, "You better not let go, you fool. If you let go, the current's going to smash you on the rocks and you're going to die a whole lot quicker than boredom." But the one heeded them not, and taking a breath, he did let go. And at once he was smashed and tumbled on the rocks. But in time, the current lifted him up, and the creature refused to cling. And the current lifted him up from the bottom, and he was bruised and hurt no more. And the creatures downstream, to whom he was a stranger, cried, "See, a miracle, a creature like ourselves, yet he flies. He must be the Messiah. He's come to save us all." And the one carried in the current said, "I'm no more a Messiah than you are. I've just let go. The river delights to lift us free and let us fly. If only we dare to let go, our true work is the voyage of this adventure." But they didn't let go, and they cried more, "Savior, Savior," all the while clinging to the rocks. And when they looked up again, he was gone, and they were left alone making legends of a savior. And that seems to be what we've done. You know, Jesus told us that we are like him, that they were all sons of God. We all have this power to become one with him, to become one with God. Like I talked about, the kingdom of God is within each and every one of us. We're all a majority. We're all a majority with God. Each of us is the most important thing. So getting in the flow of life. My wife's a Pisces. So we talk about, I'm like, "So which fish are you today? The one swimming upriver or the one swimming downriver? Are you going with the flow or are you against the flow?" And so often we find ourselves swimming up the river, just going against the flow. It's one of our jokes, you know, we're like, "Why don't you change which fish you are today and be the one going with the thing?" So in the book Illusions, there's a little handbook for the Messiah. It's called the Reminders for the Advanced Souls. And I really think that's what each and every one of us in here are. We are the advanced souls. So the master believes it's okay. It's okay to think of us as the sons of God. You don't have to put anybody between you and God. You get a direct line. You get to be right there. "You shall do all things that I have done because I go to the Father." So we are all sons or children of this great being, this great I am. Another thing it says in the handbook is your only obligation in this lifetime is to be true to yourself. Being true to anyone or anything else is not only impossible, but kind of the work of the fake Messiah. Thinking I can do something for you or you can do something for me. But when we do something for ourselves and we become one with this power, this great power of love, this harmonious power, we do something for everyone at the same time. And the more we do that, the more we lift this world up. People have asked me, you know, "Why do you do that meditation every day? You do the same meditation, the same thing every day, day after day. Today is like day 2700. I've been doing it for, you know, 7 years in a row." And I always say, I only do it for one reason. I do it for myself. I hope that someone else I might help through it. But in general, it's a selfish journey. My meditation, my prayer life is extremely selfish. Yes, I pray for others, but it's me first, putting myself first. And when you do that is when you can really help others. So Oprah Winfrey was talking to a bunch of people, and they're like, and she was talking to mothers in general. Said, "Do you put yourself first?" "No, I put my children first, and then my husband." And she was like, "You need to rethink this. You need to put yourself first." I'm like, how are we supposed to do that? And she's like, "Well, once you do that, then you can truly be of service to others. And until you do that, you really can't." So we're learning just to be playful spiritual beings. Cosmic law is like attracts like. We are magnets. And if we're healthy individuals creating a happy, healthy life, that's what we're going to attract to us, is happy, healthy individuals. And that's why I think that this unity world is so awesome, because we attract a very high level of people here. This entire world, this is again from the handbook, is our imagination. And where our thinking is, that's what we'll be attracting to us. So our idea is, well, we better think better and better so I can attract better and better things. It will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And the kingdom of heaven is right inside each and every one of us. So as we think about what we think about, we bring about thoughts or things. To bring anything into our life, we have to imagine that it's already there. And once we can see it as ours, even though it doesn't appear there in the physical, we will have it. That's how we all watched Diane create this labyrinth. It was an unbelievable thing. It was just a pile of weeds out there, and she started telling us about it. And within 6 months, we had this world-class labyrinth. But no money, no nothing. It was just visual, just believing. And one thing led to another. It was incredible to watch. So we have to know that we are not here to impress the world. We have to live our lives in a way that 'll make each of us happy. Make yourself happy, and then allow the world to live as it chooses, and then it'll allow me to live as I choose. There's a couple rules. Don't hurt anyone. You know, when we go through life, we want to put ourselves first, but not at the expense of someone else. We want to put ourselves first, and however we're putting ourselves first should help others and help ourselves and never hurt anybody. Anybody who's ever mattered, anybody who's ever been happy, anybody who's ever given a gift into this world has been a divinely selfish soul, living for his own best interests, no exceptions. Buggy a little bit. You're like, oh, well, that doesn't sound very nice. Sounds kind of selfish. But it's not, because only when we can truly let our light shine can we be a blessing to the world. And each of us is the light of the world. Going along with that uncomfortableness, it says, basically, we're all fakes. We're all fakes on this planet, pretending to be something we're not. Because we're all pretending to be these physical beings in here. I'm John, and we got my daughter Allie, and my sister Robin. We're all pretending to be these things, but we're all, like we talked about a couple weeks ago, we're all the great I Ams. And each of us is an I Am. Each of us is a spiritual being living a physical experience. We are spiritual beings having a physical experience. We are not physical beings in here trying to have a spiritual experience. We have to get that in the right order. So we are spiritual beings having a physical experience. You know, as far as I can see, it's all a dream. It's all kind of an illusion. And we really program it through one thing, our thoughts and our minds, our prayers and our beliefs. We do have some help, but we have to remember that. The last thing from the handbook I want to share is one that I have to remember. There's only a few people who are interested in what you have to say. But that's all right. You do not tell the quality of a master by the size of his crowds. So we don't need, you know, my mentor was an astrologer. And he was the astrologer to the stars. And he wrote a column for over 600 periodicals around the world. And he thought it was kind of like, you know, belittling astrology to write this one line thinking it would be, you know, life-changing. And his mentor said, "Do you think you can make one person's day better with your column?" And he's like, "Absolutely." He goes, "Well, if you can make one person's day better, it's not at all a problem." It was not at all a waste of time. So Charles Fillmore's sermon now will go from the current of the water to the current of electricity. And we have to understand that there's positive and negative. We're all like a battery. And without the, you know, if you can unhook the positive or the negative, there's no juice coming out of that battery. We need to have both. We need to have the positive and the negative to really get any electrical current going. So if we want to be a battery, we need to have both. We just need to understand them and balance them. The problem in life is people go way to one side. They go way to the negative, and so they're only getting the negative, or they go actually way to the positive, and they don't get any of the balance. So we need to have it. So electricians tell us even the smallest particle in life has both positive and negative. You've heard it before. Our cells are not actually connected. They're not actually touching. We're like walking along, and each cell is separate. Like you can, if you, you know, magnified a billion times, you can see that each cell is not even touching itself. But somehow we're held together with this incredible force. And if that were to leave, we'd all disintegrate just like that. So we have to understand that that flows through us. I said before, we need to plug in. I like to look at electricity. God is always there for us, but if we don't plug in, he can't do anything for us. Once we do plug in, it's omnipotent and omniscient, all-knowing and all-powerful, everywhere present. So the earth is a magnet, and we're all stuck to it. If it was tuned up a little bit, you know, if we're on a different planet, we'd probably all get squished down to the bottom, and if we're on another planet, we'd all fly away like feathers. But this particular planet has given us the perfect amount of magnetism, perfect amount of oxygen, perfect amount of everything that we need to live healthy, happy lives. And our minds, our souls are also polarized. And they're polarized with our thoughts, good and bad. And when the laws of mind are understood, this is from Charles Fillmore, and men learn how to control the currents of the body, and mentally moving upon words combined with the life forces in the organism, they gain control and can learn what Jesus Christ demonstrated. He was the way shower. You know, that's how we look at Jesus in unity. He showed us, he proved it. He like proved the possibilities, like breaking the 4-minute mile. No one thought it was possible till the one guy did it. So the positive is from above. That's what we did in the meditation this morning, tapping ourselves into the truth, those positive things. And the negative is from below. And we get full choice. We get to choose which we want to connect ourselves and identify ourselves with. If the I am identifies itself with the current from beneath, it attaches itself to the material world and comes to know and feel in a material sense. We all do this. Each and every one of us, our physical beings, is very attached to that material world. And we all do that. What we don't all do is the spiritual awakening. And that's when we rise up to the higher self. And that's why I think we all come to unity, is to actually connect us to those higher thoughts. So Charles Fillmore said, by making a definite and conscious union with the Father, man will come to know his spiritual relation to God and a new world. Jesus talked to the positive pole of his being, God. And if we talk as he talked, we can start to get the same results. The third way I wanted to look at flow was the vibration. You know, what is the vibration that each of you bring? Are you bringing, you know, they always say, show up with your highest vibration. What is the vibration? This is where positive and negative don't have to be balanced so much. We can actually bring more positive than we do negative. But all, and I love this from Charles Fillmore, he says, we live in a sea of vibratory energy, and we can poise ourselves in that sea where we will. All vibrations are polarized in affirmations, good and bad. We can create exactly what we create with the same ingredients, the same method gets us what we want and gets us what we don't want. So So we have to take all the vibrations, our manifestations of I am statements. I say this over and over, week after week. It's not about John Denny, but it's about my I am. And when I start to make those realizations, John Denny is the benefactor of them or the recipient of them if they're not what I would like them to be. So keeping them high, high as we can. Seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. So we can become a new creature in Christ Jesus. And Christ Jesus is the name of the higher man, the spiritual man, the man expressed through the person in those I am statements. A new kingdom is being set up in the earth, and it must include all people. It begins with the individual and spreads from one to many in unity and perfect obedience to Spirit. Again, those are Charles Fillmore's words, not mine, but I like them, so I think that they're really good to go with. So in bringing consciousness and the kingdom of God, and the kingdom of God is love, gratitude, and forgiveness. We can use those three things over and over. We seem to win every problem and solve every problem, win every argument. Love, gratitude, and forgiveness. We bring those into the soul and the body, and the outer will be as the inner, the below as above, and the will of God will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So what can we do about it? Go with the flow. Be the fish that swims downstream. Be that creature who can let go and stop clinging for a minute and realize that God will help us along and bring us exactly what we want. Go with the flow. Plug in. Balance the polarity. Balance the negative and positive. Know that all things are working for our good. Affirmations. Affirm what you want and not what you don't want. Don't go around finding yourself complaining and, you know, a bad word in my mind, you know, but complaining. Don't go along complaining all the time, because you're going to get exactly what you want, what you don't want. And then, most importantly, put yourself first every day. Put yourself high on that list. Number one, make yourself the most important thing in your life, because then you can be important to other people. And don't expect anyone else to do it for you, because they can't. You know, each of us can be there for each other, but none of us can solve each other's problems and be there what we want. Getting in the flow, then raising our vibration so that when people see you, they just, like, you know, they want to be with you. You let your light shine and you will attract to you exactly what you are. So getting in the current of life. So now, just let us take one moment, taking a deep breath, and going back to that place where God is and I am. And when we're in this place, it's a place of total love. We know God is love. Perfect, unconditional love. And we get to this place through an attitude of gratitude. I am grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And we stay there in an attitude of forgiveness, taking accountability for everything that's going on in my life. I am sorry. Please forgive me. If there's anything I've done to fall short of these higher thoughts. And for that, we say thank you, God. And before we hear another song from Dave, before we take our offerings, I would just like to, again, extend the invitation. If anybody would like to stick around for a little while, here comes Michael. Okay. But, yeah, you're not allowed to run out of here right now. We're going to need you. Uh-oh, Deb. Well, I'll invite him back too, but you're all welcome to stay for the wedding and as we join Michael and Debbie in holy matrimony. So thank you so much for your time today, and let your light shine. go with the flow. Have a great week.
That was awesome, John. Thanks. I feel charged up. Hopefully everybody else does. Ba-dum-bum, right? I have to find the right page. Okay. All right, now we move into our celebration of abundance. It's our opportunity to give back from our financial abundance. Let's begin with reading the Unity of Jupiter Prosperity Blessing together. Inner universe, overflowing with the abundance of good, we acknowledge God as the source of all our blessings. We affirm our receptivity and acceptance of this good from every direction, known, unknown, expected and unexpected. Our abundant good comes to us now. Thank you, God, and so it is. There are many ways to give. You can drop your gift in the baskets or the bags in this case. Or you can go and text it to 561-581-1119. Or you can stop by the office and donate by credit or debit card after the service. Most of these can be set up for reoccurring donations if you choose to do so. To keep our time of giving sacred, I would like you to now take your gift in your hand and bless it. You're planting the seeds to your own prosperity and giving back to God from the abundance that has already been provided for you. Breathe life into your gift. And thank God that you have this gift to give. Now affirm with me the offertory blessing. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And now David.
I'm going to be a rabble rouser. One, two. This is not my song. This song is a beautiful song written by Dan Fogelberg called Nexus. All this talk of energy, I thought it would be right. Across the vein of night, there cuts a path of Syrian light, burning like a beacon on the edges of our sight. At the point of total darkness, where the light's divine divide, soul can let its shadow stretch, land on either side, either side. Unbalanced on the precipice, the moment must reveal, naked in the face of time, our race within the wheel. We hang beneath the heavens and we hover over hell. Hearts become the instruments we learn to play so well. So wealthy the spirit who knows his own flight. Stealthy the hunter who slays his own fright. Blessed the traveler who journeys the length of the light. By the pull of gravity, beyond the spectral veil, within our careful reasoning, we search to no avail. For a constant in the chaos, for a fulcrum in the void, following a destiny our steps cannot avoid. Across the vein of night, there cuts a path of Syrian light, burning like a beacon on the edges of our sight. At the point of total darkness, where the light's divine divide, so can let its shadow stretch and land on either side. So wealthy the spirit who knows his own flight. Stealthy the hunter who slays his own fright. Blessed the traveler who journeys the length of the line. Yeah, 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 oh, yeah, yeah. Spiral never ending as we're drawn towards the source, spinning at the mercy of an unrelenting force. We stare into the emptiness far beneath the weight, circling the nexus and the fever dance with fate. So be the spirit who knows its own flight. Stealthy the hunter who slays his own fright. Blessed the traveler who journeys the length of the line. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Thank you guys for letting me sing to you today and sharing your love back to you. Thank you, John.
Well, that got the current flowing, didn't it? Wow. Huh. Thank you, David. That was a little uplifter there. Channeling your inner Dan Fogelberg. First time doing that or no?
Oh, no.
Well, again, thank you all for coming. Please stay to enjoy the wedding if you'd like to. And let's please bring the gifts forward. And I just would first like to bless all the givers. Thank you so much for your gift. And just know that it's in giving that we receive. And everyone's gift will be returned to them multiplied. That is a guarantee. If it's given from the heart in true faith, it'll come to us returned. If we have any prayer chaplains besides Jill here today, let us come on up and we offer ourselves in prayer to anybody who is in need of prayer. And now let's just remember that God's law is abundant supply. We always have enough and to spare for our every need, and that includes unity of Jupiter. So we say thank you, God, for this expression of abundance, knowing that we'll have enough for this ministry to go forward into the future. And we thank each and every person who is given. And let us take all the prayers in this prayer box and we put them again into God's hands, knowing that God is omniscient, all-knowing. He already knows what each and every one of these people need. We put the prayer in the prayer box because we're not sure. But we place it in there knowing that God already has the answer, and actually the prayers are already answered. And we say each and every week, thank you, God, for answered prayers. So each and every one of you just say, thank you, God, for answered prayers. Thank you, thank you. And now, if you'll all rise, join hands, we'll sing the peace song followed by the prayer for protection.